Hi guys, Shama Maher here, CEO of Scaling Retail, and thanks for joining me for another piece of exclusive video content. Today I want to chat with you about the three ways in order to make negotiations be a little easier for yourself. You know, as a business owner, you are constantly negotiating on all sorts of things, whether it is an employee salary, hiring out a new vendor, or even being able to negotiate between your own time, right? So negotiations are certainly something that you should be no stranger to. However, the mindset and the ways to negotiation are certainly areas in which you could probably always be improving on. So step number one to negotiating a little bit better is really to understand and take yourself out of this emotional equation of negotiations. You know, as a business entity, you will always be getting vendors, you will always be hiring, and it's important to be able to ask for a discount when you need one. It doesn't mean that the person that you're asking a discount from is going to say yes all the time. In fact, sometimes they might say no, but it never hurts to ask. And when you can start to realize that by asking for a discount, you're not necessarily diminishing that person's value, you're simply saying, hey, is it possible to get a little bit of a price break here? You're actually able to see if there's any wiggle room. And chances are, when you ask for a discount, you might be able to get one. You know, too often do first-time entrepreneurs fail to negotiate when they're starting up their businesses. And it never means that someone's always going to be able to get a discount. But if you don't ask, guys, you simply will have no idea if you can save 50 bucks here, 100 bucks there. It is all for the betterment of your business. Now, step number two when it comes to negotiations, you really want to know at the end of the day exactly what you're trying to get out of this relationship. Meaning, if you're negotiating with points on a contract, if you're negotiating between time, if you're negotiating or working with a new employee and their salary, you really want to have a strong idea of what it is you are really willing to pay here and what the qualifications and what the bullet points are of what you're trying to satisfy. Without having done your due diligence on how much you're willing to spend, you won't actually be able to know what the right price points are that you should be looking for. And without having a full comprehensive understanding of what you need someone to be doing for you, you may not actually be able to beef up that scope of work as you would prefer, as you would had you done that investigation. So while you're in the process of getting proposals, in the process of hiring, or even negotiating on a number of other factors, outline for yourself what the prices are that you're really ideally looking for. And then mutually exclusive to the price, write down all of the things that you need to be satisfying here. What are the requirements that you need? There is going to be a happy medium here in the middle, right? Ideally, we are looking for the right vendor, the right person who can really satisfy both the price point we're looking for, if not a little bit less, or getting all of the things that we want done in terms of those requirements. Too often we settle, right? We take the first proposals we get, we evaluate them purely on what they are, and we don't go back and renegotiate. That is the number one thing that most newbies do. Even seasoned entrepreneurs will sometimes overlook, you know, the aspects of negotiations because they're in a hurry in order to make a decision. So when it comes to hiring, make sure that you get a few different proposals. Make sure you get a few different contract opportunities, right? Make sure you examine the scope of work, you know? So negotiations will always end up being in your favor as long as you go into it with that kind of foresight of what you're looking for. Now, the third thing to realize with negotiations is that you're dealing with people. You're dealing with normal people, with their emotions, with their day-to-days, which means that when you come to negotiations, if you are going to take a really strict standpoint on that and say, hey, this is what I need, either you can do it or you can't do it, be willing to be able to walk away from that, right? You don't want to put your fist down and be tough at the negotiating table if you're not going to be able to really stand by what it is that you're asking for, or if you're on the counter side and let's say you're dealing with a wholesale vendor and man, this retailer is really trying to get you to negotiate your prices down. If you can't stand there and say, no, I can't go down from this, or yes, here is how I can negotiate. If you're not willing to be firm about this, then it really does not put you in the best position possible. So as an entrepreneur in retail, the negotiations will happen both ways. Obviously, your buyers will always ask for a discount. Why not, right? It is their prerogative to ask for a discount, just as you ask for a discount from any vendors who you're working with. So if a buyer does ask, hey, can I get 8%, 10% off? It's not because they undervalue your product. It's really because it's their job. Their job is to negotiate with you. Their job is to get the best deal always. So put your entrepreneurial cap on, start to think about the ways in which you can start to implement aspects of negotiations into the daily working practice, right? As you are, again, hiring vendors, buying from different suppliers and sourcing, and as you are going out there in the market, and let's say you're selling wholesale, and a buyer is looking to negotiate with you, you need to know, again, what is your bottom price? You don't want to be wishy-washy. Either you're able to give a discount or you're unable to. And certainly when you're dealing with wholesale buyers and you are able to give them a discount, don't offer the discount up front. You know, you want to get them to love your product. You want to get them to buy your product because they see a lot of potential there and they see it's going to be a great added value to their assortment. You don't want them to be buying your product simply because it's cheap. So save those discounts for when you're closing the deal. Similarly, as a vendor you might hire wouldn't just come out and say, hey, I'll give you a 10% discount just because. They're going to wait and interject that deal because they want to close the sale, right? First, they want to see if you're interested, and then they've got to lock it up. All right, guys, good luck with negotiations. Remember, take your emotions out of it. Think long term. These are strategic partners for you. You know, when you hire someone on a contract, it's not just one and done. This is someone who you're hopefully going to be working with as you build and grow your team. Similarly, these retailers, they get it. They're never going to ask aggressively for a discount for you or from you, but they are going to ask, and they're going to do so politely, and it's really up to you to decide whether or not you can give it or not. And if, guys, a retailer does ask for a discount, you can simply negotiate on that as well. They ask for 10%, you say, I can give you 8. You know, chances are you're going to find, again, a happy medium. So guys, business of retail is bartering, negotiating always. There's always a trade-off. There's always something going on. Remember, it doesn't mean that you're undervaluing someone's time, who they are as a person. And it doesn't mean that they're undervaluing you when they ask for a discount. You know, discounts are the ways that things go. Negotiations happen all the time. And remember, negotiations happen not just with price points, but also with scope of work, right? Maybe you want to keep that price point the same, but you want to add in a couple other bullet points because you want to make sure you can get a little bit more out of that contract. All right, guys, enough for me. Enjoy the retail process. Have fun negotiating. Good luck with your businesses. Reach out, hello@scalingretail.com. Would love to hear from you and hear how you're doing with negotiations. All right, talk to you later. Bye.